unscrewed off his brain and just like plopped it down, sort of bomb, 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 like put it back in. It's like, all right, let's play, guys.
Hello and welcome to Blue Jays Today, where we always have something to say about the Blue Jays. I'm your host, Adam Peddle.
And I'm your host, Nick Palaiolog. And today we're going to be talking to you about something that, well, it's really kind of scary right now, and that's the possibility that baseball could finish literally any day. I don't even know, but please subscribe to our videos because this could be one of the last ones with active baseball. You want to talk about this, Adam? Like,
yeah.
What the hell is going on right now, man? Like, what? Like, there's people going to strip clubs. Like, there's teams that are being, like, just, like, no one's playing. Like, what is happening?
Yeah. Okay. So, the most recent news on cancellation is the Cardinals and the Tigers series just got postponed because the Cardinals have 13 cases of COVID-19.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
See, I didn't even know that. It's like, every day I check, I open up my app and I'm like, oh, like all of these guys, COVID-19, like
postponed. Yeah, like, I mean, if you guys have been around, like, if you're Phillies fans, Phillies have been postponed. Jays have been postponed because mm-hmm. we're supposed to face the Philly. And Miami's been postponed. New York's been postponed. But recently, actually, Philly has played their first game in over 8 days. And Miami's supposed to play, I don't know, this video whenever comes out, Miami's supposed to be playing very shortly against the Orioles. But thing is, people are getting COVID.
Yeah, dude. And here, I'm sorry to cut you off. But you were talking about teams getting postponed. I actually wrote out all of the teams, and like I didn't even know about this one. So that would add like St. Louis. Oh no, I have St. Louis down actually. So there is Miami, St. Louis, Milwaukee, Toronto, New York, Washington, Philly, Cincinnati, Detroit, Chicago Cubs, the Orioles, the White Sox, the Indians. Every single one of those teams has had a postponement so far because of COVID.
Because of COVID.
Yeah.
Man. Like, that's a lot of teams. And, you know, it's like, here's the thing. We all kind of knew it was going to happen. You'd have to be pretty ignorant to think, oh, there's no way no one's getting COVID throughout the entire season without a bubble. If you're flying from city to city, from state to state, especially in Florida, where it all began, then someone is going to catch it. And what do you do if 15, you know, 10 plus people get it? What they did is they canceled series. But you're only canceling for 7 days, and isn't it supposed to be 14 days?
Well, that's literally what I'm thinking too, man, is like, are these players even ready to go?
Yeah.
Like, what? Like, what if they still have it? Then we're just going to give it to more teams, you know? Like, it doesn't make any sense, you know? Yeah. And can we also just talk about, like, the reports of Miami, like, possibly going out and stuff? Like, that is ridiculous.
On their way to Atlanta during summer camp, they Derek Jeter commented on this, addressing the Marlins outbreak. And he quoted this, saying, Marlins got relaxed and let their guard down, which, you know, if you're a professional athlete knowing that you're going to be quarantined in a bubble, letting your guard down, going out in the public, going to bars and restaurants, that's pretty irresponsible.
Bro, you let your guard down when you, like, pull your mask down to say something to someone. You don't let your guard down when you go and get hammered at some, like, bar or club or maybe even strip club is what I've heard.
With no mask.
With no... Well, I mean, like, it doesn't even matter.
That's just a cherry on top of irresponsible.
Yeah, it's like, bro, can you actually imagine? It's like the Miami players, and it's like, guys, it's fine. Like, I have my mask on. Like, it's all good. Like, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
No, it is not all good. You went out, man.
Yeah.
You wanted to get drunk. I understand, but come on. You got to get paid how much?
Yeah, you're a professional athlete. Like, you shouldn't be doing that. And so that thing is, they're not being punished at all. There's been no precautions put in place. If someone were to break these rules, what happens to them? That they didn't even, they were just like, oh yeah, they're so blind. This whole season is so blind to, you know, like, oh, it's gonna be fine. It's gonna be great. Oh, this will be okay. No, we have an IL system for if someone gets COVID. Oh, what happens if they all get COVID? Ah, we'll see.
Yeah, bro. And like, here's my thing too, is like, like, people get COVID, I understand, like, if it's all accidental and stuff, but, like, when it's on purpose, like, I that to me is, like, a little bit unacceptable. And it's also kind of helping Miami a little bit. Like, right now, they're second in their division. Because it's based off of win, and that's another thing, win percentage. Like, what is going to happen? Like, is Miami going to get to make up all those games? Like, there are some teams, like Philly today. Philly only played their fourth game today. Some teams have played, like, 10, you know?
Here's the thing, too. And you have Rob Manfred being like, oh, like, we don't really want to play into November, October. Like, we don't want to get into that. But you're going to have to.
Yeah, bro. Like,
you kind of have to.
What, like, what month are you thinking of? Like, you think October? Like, that doesn't exist, Manfred. There's no month.
You think that it's just like, oh, like, the schedule is what it's going to be, and, like, nothing's going to change for it. Well, first of all, you have weather pros months you didn't count for. And then you got, you know, COVID. You got to start. If you're going to start counting COVID as an IL spot, you got to start counting COVID as, like, a schedule changing spot later on. And you're going to see a lot of double headers happening. But if we can't fit in those double headers, like, if we, you know, for example, I believe we do face Philly again later in the season, but if we don't, then, you know, if hypothetically we didn't, we'd have to then make it up at the end of the season.
Well,
in additional series.
Because, like, I've heard rumors about, like, at the end of the season, like, if all the teams are not at 60 games, which, like, right now, it's clearly we're not on pace for all the teams being at 60 games, then they were going to start thinking about literally basing it off of win percentage.
And that's ridiculous.
Well, and that's my question, too, is, like, so, like, what if a team plays 40 games?
Yeah.
What if a team plays 30 games? Like, where's the cutoff line here as to, like, how many games does it count for? Like, if I'm a player right now, I'm going, all right, so let's just win, like, 8 out of 10 and just not play.
Yeah. Like, here's the thing. Like, you're asking, like, what happens? I don't even think they know what happens.
Dude,
I think
Manfred is straight up, like, just taking a hammer and just, like, smacking it, like, just, like, literally, like, unscrewed off his brain and just, like, plopped it down. So, like, bomb, bomb, bomb. Like, put it back in. And it's like, all right, let's play, guys. Like, baseball time.
Speaking of Manfred, he hasn't really directed any blame to the organization of this season. All he said is that the players need to be better. That he's said, quote, "We are playing. I am not a quitter in general, and there's no reason to quit now." And I get it. From a fan perspective, you jumped into it, but you got to have some sort of responsible plan B, plan C of what's going to happen if people start getting COVID. When are we going to make up these seats? And you got to be able to be flexible later on. That's all I'm saying.
I don't even understand what he means by that. Like, I am not a quitter. Like, okay, like, no one is saying that. Okay. Yeah, like, it's not like, oh my God, like, Manfred, quit. Like, you're horrible. No, dude, we're just saying, like, maybe, like, stop smacking your brain with a hammer and, like, use it.
Yeah.
You know?
Use your brain. Look at what the NBA is doing. Like, you know why it took them so long to get going? They were even playing this before you even decided on the season. I know there was this quick rush to get summer camp up and going, but you should have been planning for this while you were off, you know, wherever you were during the quarantine. You should have been planning, but that's your job.
Yeah,
that's
bro.
That's your job.
Dude, like, when we were watching the Leafs game the other day, like, I was watching it, and, like, just the way that they had it all set up, and they had, like, screens of fans there and stuff, and I was like, damn, like, if I'm the MLB, I'm, like, straight embarrassed right now. These guys, like, just rocked, like,
they
crushed me, man. Yeah,
they killed it,
man.
And guess what? They don't have as many, they don't have even close to as many cases. I don't know the exact number, but it's very, very, very dismal.
Yo, what do you think, like, do you think this gets canceled? Because I remember we heard a rumor where, like, the MLB was, like, to television broadcasters, like, maybe you guys should start planning to fill our time that you would typically broadcast the MLB. Like,
here's the thing, and I'm going to be straight up honest. Literally no idea.
Yeah.
Like, you got Manfred, who has ego issues and doesn't want to be known as the guy who failed.
Yeah.
And then you have everyone on his team and health and safety and owners. And some owners are still actually down to keep playing because what's it all about? The money.
Yeah, yeah.
They want to make the money. But then you have other people saying, you know what, maybe it should be best. Like, this is a little bit dangerous and we should. But no, they're just going to put their heads right in the sand again. Keep steamrolling through and get the season done and make their dollars.
Yeah, seriously. But, like, I wouldn't be surprised if we woke up tomorrow, the next day, with an update being like, MLB is canceled. There is no rescheduling. That's it, period. Wouldn't be surprised one day.
I mean, I'd just be, as a fan, I'd just be shocked. Would I be surprised? No. But I'd just be shocked because they're just steamrolling through this thing with no regard.
Yeah.
They're improvising. They're just improvising.
Yeah, they're straight winging it right
they're
now.
They're winging it. No one's planning anything. No one's thought of, like, maybe they have. Obviously, I'm not commissioner of baseball or on that committee or whatever. But you should have been planning this and made it vocally known what's going to happen. I bet they've already had several questions saying, what's going to happen if this happens, if people start getting COVID? Do they have an answer? I haven't seen one.
Yeah. We're going to have to wait and see, man.
Yeah.
But, guys, let us know what you think. Like, how worried should we be right now? Like, what's the next team that's going to get hit with the outbreak? Because we already know that it's coming.
It is coming.
It's undeniable. So please let us know in the comments down below.
Make sure to subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on our Spotify, Google Podcasts, Anchor, Branker, and Radio Public. And as well, follow us on our Instagram.
Thank you so much for watching.
And go Jays, go.